Hey friends, in this video we are going to talk about our text features focus for the week, which is captions. And we're going to read a story, a piece of informational text that has captions in it, and we're going to know how to recognize them and what they do to a story. So this piece of informational text that we are going to read is called See Our Country. So let's get started. There are many places to visit in the United States. This is the Statue of Liberty in New York City. Lady Liberty is a symbol of freedom. She welcomes people to our country. What a beautiful sight! Now I noticed that there are also some words that are right here in this red box. In this red box, we can see that it is right next to the picture of the Statue of Liberty. So because this red box is separate from all of the other words on the page, and because this red box is right next to the picture, we can tell that the words in this red box is a caption for this picture. And a caption captions give more information about the photograph. So let's read this caption and see what new information we are going to find out about the Statue of Liberty. It says, "The Statue of Liberty was a gift from France." Oh, so the American people got the Statue of Liberty as a gift. Huh, interesting. Let's keep reading. "Let's travel west to South Dakota. Mount Rushmore is a monument carved into a mountain. It took many years to build. This monument honors four American presidents." Now I see in this orange box that there are words that are separate from all of the other words, and these words in this orange box are right next to this picture of Mount Rushmore. So this tells me visually that the words in this orange box is a caption for this photo. So it's going to give us more information about Mount Rushmore. Let's read and see what it says. "The four presidents on Mount Rushmore are George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Theodore Roosevelt, and Abraham Lincoln." So this caption has now told us each of these faces, the names of each of these faces that are carved onto this rock. Huh. That's some new information. I didn't know that. "The Everglades is a national park in Florida. Many different kinds of animals live there together. About 350 different kinds of birds live in the park. What other places would you like to visit to learn about our country?" I see that there are two pictures on this page, and it looks like there are two captions. I think that because this blue caption is right under this picture, that this caption is going to tell us more about this picture of this bird that we see here. Let's read and see what that says. Let's see what we can learn about this bird. It says, "The great blue heron lives in the Everglades." Oh, so now we know that this bird is called a great blue heron. Wait a minute. Where is the Everglades? I can't remember. But I think I remember it in our story. So I'm going to reread some of the text to see if I can remember where the Everglades are. It says, the Everglades is a national park in Florida. Oh, okay. So if the Everglades is a national park in Florida, like I just read, then having reread that, I know that the great blue heron lives in Florida. So now we've looked at that caption in the blue box. Now let's look at the caption in the green box. And since the caption is right under the picture, I know that this caption is going to give us more information about the picture that we see above it. So let's see what it says. It says, the alligator lives in the Everglades too. Oh, so now that caption has told me where I could find an alligator if I ever wanted to see one from a very, very far, far, far away distance. So now I want you, with your teacher in your class, I want you guys to turn to page 91 of your close reading companion. And I have a couple questions that I want you guys to think about. As we looked at the three different places in this informational text, what is similar about these locations? How are these locations the same? And how are these locations different? My second question, well, third question. My third question is, why do you think the author wrote the story as if it were handwritten? Because if we look at, that was close. If we look at the letters in the story, if we look at the letters in the story, it kind of looks like someone wrote it with their hand. Why do you think the author made it look like someone was writing on a piece of paper? And then the last question that I want you to think about is, what, on page 25, what helps us learn more about the kinds of animals that live in the Everglades? And how does it help? Talk about these things with your class.